through the mist by the milk light of moon. All that was lost is revealed. Our long bygone burdens, mere echoes of the spring. But where have we come? And where shall we end? If dreams can't come true, then why not pretend? How the gentle wind beckons through the leaves as autumn colors fall.
Somewhere lost in the clouded annals of history lies a place that few have seen. A mysterious place called the unknown, where long forgotten stories are revealed to those who travel through the wood.
So basically, I was sent kind of information about the show, brief synopsis about these two young brothers who get lost in the unknown, this forest, and the sort of people they meet along the way. And then the artwork. And it was really, honestly, the artwork that kind of drew me in. It's sort of, it evoked, you know, cartoons that we haven't seen in a long time, the idea of something that's hand-painted, 2D cell animation. It was sort of like this idea of taking something from the old world and bringing it into people's living rooms now, which is an exciting prospect.
It's an animated series about two brothers who are lost in this mysterious forest world where they go from one adventure to another as they travel, trying to get home.
Okay, everybody, act natural.
Drummy, drummy.
I said act natural.
It is natural. I'm a drum.
I grew up in New Jersey, and the seasons that happen over there were something that when I came out to California, I started missing more and more, and I didn't really expect to. So the show has like a fall theme that kind of goes to winter as it changes.
Tell me a little bit about the two brothers themselves and how different they're going to play from each other.
Wirt is the older brother, and he's more afraid of life and more internal, poetic in some ways. And then the younger brother has a good time all the time, isn't afraid of anything, and really looks up to his older brother.
He's an outcast, and he's cold. Feel these cold feet.
No, he's supposed to be cold, Greg. He's a frog.
Tell us a little bit about this journey and what exactly does Over the Garden Wall mean.
Well, Over the Garden Wall has similar meaning to like Through the Looking Glass or something, where it's this other place that is full of unknown things. It starts off seeing these two brothers realizing they're lost, and as we travel through, they meet a bluebird named Beatrice who helps them along on their journey, leading them to Adelaide of the Pasture, who's sort of a Wizard of Oz type goal for them.
Don't know who she is or how she is or when or why she is, but as for where she is, where we will go. To Adelaide, come on and join the Adelaide Parade.
No.
Adelaide, to Adelaide, let's go to Adelaide's house. We're going to the pasture to meet Adelaide and ask her if she has a way to send us back where we came from. I don't know who she is or how she is or when or why she is, but as for where she is where we will go.
To Adelaide, Adelaide,
come on and join the Adelaide Parade.
Adelaide, to Adelaide, we're going to Adelaide's house today.
When the lake is a mirror, and the moon rides the waves to the shore, a single soul sets his voice singing, content to be slightly forlorn. A song rises over the lilies, sweeps high to clear over the reeds. And over the bulrushes sway to pluck at a pair of heartstrings.
Hey, Beatrice, thanks for supporting my bassooning.
Yeah, you're actually good.
The best part is, we're still on track to get to Adelaide's.
Yep, that's great.
You don't seem thrilled.
Well, I don't want you to... Never mind, never mind.
Carries their reverie.
Huh?
treetops and mountains, over the blackened ravines. Then softly it falls by a house near a stream and over the garden wall to thee.
I knew you were special.
I'm just lost. See, we're trying to get to...
I'm the highwayman.
Okay, good to know. Well, so you see...
I'm the highwayman. I make ends meet, just like any man. I work with my hands. If you cross my path, I'll knock you out right off the road. Steal your shoes from off your feet. I'm the highwayman, and I make ends meet.
The mill is destroyed. The oil, all gone.
But look, we got the beast problem solved.
The dog? That is not the beast. The beast cannot be mollified like some farmer's pet. He stalks like the night. He sings like the four winds. He is the death of hope. He steals their children, and he'll ruin the...
You're always messing up, Greg.
Boy, you have it backwards. You are the elder child. You are responsible for you and your brother's actions.
I'm sorry. Maybe I can fix it? I can't fix it.
You must go. Take your brother north. Look for a town.
Yeah, thanks. Come on, Greg.
One last thing. Beware the unknown. Fear the beast and leave these woods if you can. It is your burden to bear.
Right, yeah, got it.
And little one, you look after that frog. Give him a proper name.
Okay.